Good morning. Roxy's Journal of Stitchery, next page, which is a snowman. I think she said trees as well, but I'm just going to do a snowman. So, this is my layout. I've been faffing with it for a bit, but you know, like you do. I'll talk you through it. So, it's one of my baby wipes that, you know, get stained up in arty stuff. So, I've put that in the background because I thought that looked quite nice, blue and snowy. Snowman, I've made it out of felt. I did die cut it. He's gone a bit wobbly. Yeah, I thought I'd do felt circles. I was going to do the turned one like Rachel did, but I'm going to go felt. I have a piece of this twisted sari ribbon stuff for his arms. I found my little Diddy Bird buttons. So little Robin, I just coloured his chest and the rest of him. So he's going to sit on the arm of the snowman like so. And then I've got a piece of lace here, obviously, which I'm just going to stitch down. I've got a Suffolk puff at the top, that top there, which is in like a nice, I think I used those in my hexi puff bag, didn't I? The grey ones. So I have one of those left. I've got a big wooden snowflake. So not quite sure how I'm going to attach that yet. If I attach it up there, it's going to keep pinging up, so I might have to stitch across it. We'll come to that. Cross that bridge when we come to it. I've got a bit of violet lace here, and then I've got this super sparkly ribbon from craftyribbons.com. I've had it a while. I don't know if you can pick up the sparkle there, and I thought that would look quite nice across the top there as snow, basically. I've got a piece of old crocheted doily thing there, which is obviously a circle. I have had these tree buttons forever. They're little tiny Christmas trees, so I thought I'd put that on there. Oh, and the little diddy buttons, I don't know, I bought these ages ago from China. They're 6 millimeter. You get 600, you get 200 in a bag, and they're from Bedia accessories. They're the little, I think they call them scrapbooking buttons. I don't know why, but they do. So 6 millimeter buttons for his coal buttons, basically. I've drawn in his features at the moment because I thought it'd be easier if I draw them in and then embroider over the top. So for his mouth, I've just done little dots, which I will use. Oh, I thought I've got a blackout. I will use French knots for those in black. I've got the orange for his nose. I've got the sort of peachy pink for his cheeks. Again, that might just be a big French knot that I do for those. Coal black eyes, obviously. Oh, and I've done him a scarf. I've got this baker's twine in those colours, obviously. And I just crocheted. Just single crochets, well, like a chain basically, and I thought that would look quite good as a scarf, so I shall stitch that on there somehow. Like that. What do you reckon? It's all right, isn't it? So, first things first, I'm going to dismantle it all. for the holding the background down, I don't know if you remember when I did that one. Yeah, I did the snowflakes by fly stitch snowflakes. So I thought I'd do some of those in the background there just to pin that all down. I thought that would work quite well. Who knows? I don't know how long this video will be. I will probably just do sort of like half and then carry on with another video. Sorry, I've broke my nail and it's incredibly bitty. You know what it's like when you break a nail. Right, let's put you there. Let's deconstruct you there. Now, oh, Mr. Snowman. Oh, and I just got a piece of linen that I had. Right, we'll just pile you. Keep all your components together. Let's put you up there. Right, okay, so let's get the background done first. So yeah, these baby wipes, telling you, really helpful. Okay, I was thinking about doing in this weird and wonderful thread, which I clean forgot to take with me to Chagford show, as I say, because what's her name? The lady, anyway, that organises it, she does tatting, and it does say on there something about tatting. So, don't know. I just wonder if they're going to be a bit chunky. Because I think those last ones I did in that. Oh no, I did sparkly pink. Yeah, but that was a pain, wasn't it? It kept on. It kept on separating. Sorry, I'll finish that sentence. I haven't done them anywhere else, have I? No. I'm going to try the silver. I'll try this thick one. If it looks too bulky, then I'll just take it out and we'll do something else. So I had a pair of scissors here. They're in there. So I hope everybody's good. It is Monday today. I have skived off Pilates. I'm probably going to regret it come the end of the week, but because I'm babysitting the giant hound Hades, my daughter texted me last night and she said, do you want to try a morning walk with him, like today while she's here technically? And I was like, yeah, I need to do that because he is a big boy, and you know, when he lunges, I think she was worried that he would pull me over. But so anyway, I said to her, well, what time? She said, well, I generally take him out about six and seven rather. Oh, sorry. This is a Bowen glue pen, by the way. Perfect for this kind of thing. I don't want to put pins in because it just gets painful. What was I saying? Yeah, so anyway, I said, yes, that's fine. So I went to her house today, this morning, first thing, and he was as good as gold. He did pull, but I swear my kids think I'm older than I actually am. I said to her, you do remember that I had an Alsatian and a Labrador at one time, don't you? Both together, and I used to walk them all on my own. She said, yeah, but that was a long time ago. I'm like, right, okay. So anyway, bless her. She's just looking after me. I'm just looking for her. Are you going to be wide enough? So I was out walking him for over an hour this morning. I took his lead and she just sort of followed beside us. She said, I feel odd not holding on to him. And I said, well, yeah, but I need to gauge, you know, what the pull is like on that dog when he lunges or whatever. So so we walked him down the road from where she lives, and then you can go on to a place called Hackney Marshes, which runs along the side of the River Teen, which is quite a nice walk actually. I didn't let him off. I said to her, I won't let him off. I've done videos at the Troll Bridge, as my granddaughter calls it, and I think I will walk him there more often because it's got two secure fields. You can actually lock a gate. And so basically, if he just totally disobeys me, because he does turn a deaf end when he wants to, I think that's the husky in him, it doesn't matter. He can't go past the gate because it is a huge cattle gate. So, yeah. I think I'll more or less walk him down there a lot. So it depends. I'll see. I've booked, as I say, I think I've told you before, I booked the week off anyway. Because then, I mean, I've got so much crafting I want to do, so much. I've got journals here lined up, queued up. I've got that butterfly canvas that I'm trying to get finished for that ACL Creative or whatever they were called. Oh, I've gone that too far there. Yeah, so I've got a lot of crafting I want to do. So, and as I've booked the time off, and I think it's West Point show next week, if I come across that way. So, and I can't for the life of me remember what day I booked to go. I think it was the Thursday, or it might have been the Friday. I don't know. I'll have to check. So, Yeah, so it's a busy week next week anyway with looking after him. But I kind of went on the walk just to reassure her that I would be able to manage this giant dog, so he's all right. He loves his nan. He is my grand puppy. She says she's not going to have children, but I'm like, I think you might have one. Don't know. No pressure. I said to her, it's completely up to you. It's your lifestyle choice, not mine. Mind you, I didn't want kids. I ended up with three. So I keep telling her that. I said, I didn't want children. I had three of you. Anyway. So yes, it's been a busy morning. And I thought, the thought of just going to Pilates, I was exhausted. No, because I don't walk slow. Even my daughter said that. She went, crikey, Mum, I just turn around, lock the door, and you and him were halfway down the hill. I went, yeah, well, you know, I don't walk slowly. I like to get a real pace on and blah, blah, blah. So, yeah. Yeah. I'd say it was more just to rest her mind that he wasn't going to pull me over. More than anything else. And she can go on her honeymoon and relax then, because she is so stressed out, which is not good stress. It's one of the world's biggest killers, isn't it? Not that, you know, she's only 29. I doubt it'll kill her, but yeah. If I can alleviate a bit of that stress. Oh, I'm leaning on my the nerves in my arm. Stop wiggling. A bit wonky, this one. I'll get better. It's been a while. So, and then this afternoon, I've got to meet up with my colleague. She's lending me one of her dresses for Mother of the Bride. I think I've told you this already, so I won't go on. Yeah, so I'm meeting her at 3. And now I've got a ton of posts to do, and yeah, I don't want to spend an hour. Well, I should have done really, but I'm going tomorrow night. I'm going to yoga and Pilates tomorrow night, so it'll be fine. Right, so let me just move you out of the way for a minute. That came over quite a bit, didn't it? So if I do another one up here, if I mark them, actually I don't know if I want to mark them, no, I'll just do one here and one sort of about there. I think we'll do like a triangle. Let's see how that works. Right, now concentrate on this one, no talking. Too close there. Pull it out, because you're not going to be happy with it if you don't. think it's going to pour with rain any minute. I've got washing on the line. Went to the car boot yesterday in the end, and I picked up loads of clothes for my other granddaughter, Scarlett. So I stuck them all in the wash, and oh, so cheap. I mean, seriously, if you buy your kids' clothes out of a shop, you've got to be mad. I mean, for £5, I got an animal brand sweatshirt thing with a really fluffy lining, a pair of, I don't know what you call them really, sort of like baggy trousers, if it was, as it were. I still went wonky on that one, never mind. What else did I get? Oh, fleecy onesie, you know, pyjama type thing. And, well, more or less brand new pair of, it was like shorts and a top Snoopy pyjamas. I think they were Next, those ones, from Next, the shop, the clothes shop. And yeah, it was just like £1 each. I can't remember what else I got. Something else. Nope, it's gone. I don't know. And then I picked up some sari fabric. I know. It's not like you haven't got enough, is it? But I couldn't resist it. It was £2.70. So I will show you. It's out on the line but at the moment. So. Because it really was very musty, very smelly. So, A, it needed washing, and B, it needs a good couple of hours on the line to get rid of that musty smell. Right, these aren't going very well. They're nice and sparkly, but they're a bit wonky. Where's it gone? Right, I think I'll just do one more here, because the snowman was there, wasn't he? Yeah, snowman's going there, so I think I'll just do one about here somewhere, and then that should hold that all down, because that'll all be held, and that'll be held there, so that's fine. That will do fine. You can do the invisible thing like Rachel does, but, you know, these aren't going to be worn, or, you know, they don't need to be practical pieces, let's put it like that, as in they'll stand up to handling, so, we won't go mad. I think one more about here right now. Let's see if we can actually get it looking like a snowflake this time. I was watching old Kerry the Crafter this morning doing his canvas. Yeah. I haven't gel printed for ages, and that was like, yeah, you're really giving me the urge now. I really need to get on, because I have ambition to make a load of printed fabric to put out there for other people to buy. So that is my ambition. Might get to it next week. You never know. Oh, you need to come out a bit further, don't you? But like I say, I've got all these blooming journals. I've got a queue behind me. I need to go on a retreat like Gail goes on, and then I can just concentrate on that or nothing else. They don't hold those over here, unfortunately. Well, I think they do quilting ones, don't they? But they usually in the north of England, which is a blooming long way from me, from down in the southwest. So, right, okay. Well, they're sparkly, not very snowflakish, but all right. Okay, so I need you down first. I've fluffed the edges. You can probably see that there. So you fit there, let's stay. And then you can sit there and look like snow, if you wouldn't mind. Oh dear, excuse me. Oh, I had a terrible night's sleep. Oh. Terrible. Don't know why. Right, let's get some pins, I think. Don't really like pinning things because I usually end up stabbing myself when I'm stitching. But I don't think the glue will hold that many layers. I don't know. Probably would. I bet not use those. I'm going to lose that. Those in there. Okay. I guess just a very simple running stitch. I think it, so I shall do it. It's going to be one of those days, isn't it, Susan? Yeah. My mind is racing, sat here. I'm not concentrating on this at all. So many things to get done. It's Friday. I'm going with my daughter to set up the hall for the reception. Well, and a load of other people. It's not just me and her. Yeah, just wondering about a fancy stitch, but I've only got cotton on my needle. Let's just do a running stitch, come on, keep it simple. Right, come here. So yes, it's a busy weekend and a busy week. Thankfully, it's a short work week. I've only got to work Tuesday, Wednesday this week. So that is a blessing in disguise. So Thursday, I can get a load of videos done, hopefully. Really glad the cooking videos went down all right. I know I kept using the words rocket science a lot, but really, my cooking is not rocket science. I was listening to it back and I was like, oh, stop saying it. You sound like a complete wally. So I managed to have strict words with myself. And I know there's at least one person that has taken something from it. So because it is, you know, when you're on your own, you just can't be bothered to cook sometimes. As I explained in those videos. And that's why I do the bulk thing, because, you know, now for the next 6 weeks, if not longer, I haven't even got to worry about have I got such and such in, because it's all in the cupboard or the freezer. So it's just sat there waiting to be cooked or reheated, really, not even cooked. I had the chili with chips the other night, because I love chili and chips. There's something about the vinegar, because I always have vinegar on my chips, but that with the chili, oh, it's amazing. And I did them in the air fryer, because I told you my daughter gave me one. Well, if you watch the cooking videos, I do. Anyway, oh, they came out absolutely delicious, because previously I was having to put the oven on just for a few blooming chips. And they just came out crispy, not all dried up like they do out of the oven. They were amazing, and they took 20 minutes in the air fryer. And they were amazing. And that was from frozen. They were beautiful. So I said to my daughter yesterday, because I say we went together to the car boat, I said to her, I'm so grateful for that. Thank you. And she went, well, I wasn't using it. Well, she wants a bigger one, because obviously it's her and Eleanor. Although, I don't know why. Because I'd have thought the one that she gave me would have been big enough capacity. But anyway, kids. So, yeah. So that was great. We've got to look at all this energy saving stuff, especially here in the UK. I don't know if it's like all over the world, but our prices are set to just go mental. I don't know how I'm going to afford it, but you manage, don't you, somehow? So what will really put the spanner in the works is if my manager says we've all got to go back into the office. I'll have to quit my job, because I won't be able to afford the petrol, because it's still quite high here in the UK, and doing that every day, yeah, it's not going to be financially feasible. And my daughter's so busy with the dog walking, she said, Mum, I'm pretty sure you could earn what you're earning now just dog walking. I said, yeah, but it's the risk, love. I said, you know, it's only me, and if I'm not bringing in the money, and my rent and bills don't get paid, I'm homeless. So I said, I can't afford to faff. So, yeah. She's pretty confident. She gets so many queries about dog walking. But she said, Mum, I know I can get you plenty of work. And I said, well, let's see how we go. I said, let's just play it by ear. There's some comfort in the job that I do, in that it's going to be one of those jobs that it's always, you're unlikely to be made redundant unless they decide that it's overmanned, I suppose. But that's fine. They can make me redundant. I've got 11 years with them, so it's fine. I'll get quite a nice payout, thank you very much. And then there's so many jobs around here at the moment, so I'm not really worried. I used to love temp work, you know, you used to turn up and if you didn't like the place, you could ring the agency and said, this place is dire, I'm not coming back tomorrow. And there was nothing they could do about it. So it's great. I used to get into all sorts of jobs. I did it when the kids were little, because I could never take a proper job, as it were, because their father was always away. He was Royal Navy, and he couldn't book holidays and stuff. So like for the summer holidays, if I'd have got a proper job, as it were, I'd have been paying out childcare for three children, and it just wouldn't have been worth going to work, to be honest. So I just did temping, and I loved it. I absolutely loved the freedom to just, you know, you got in a bad place and you just sort of, yeah, actually, I'm not coming back tomorrow. I always got work. So, because they knew that I could put up with all sorts of rubbish. And if I said I'm not coming back tomorrow, they usually took those people off their books, because they knew it must have been bad. So, because I was always bluntly truthful. They did this, that did that. If their staff stopped sitting around mucking about all the time, they wouldn't need a temping. You need to speak to the manager. Me, me, me. And all that sort of stuff. And they used to feed it all back. So. And they were usually quite grateful. Anyway. Having said all that rambling. Yeah. I can always go back to temp work. So. I'm just doing random stitches. You can probably see that. I don't need to tell you that. Yeah. It just needs holding down. Snowman's going over the top of this part, so that's fine. I'll check how long we've been going. Just going to run out, aren't I? Come on, stretch. Might be skin of the teeth job. Might have enough thread. Gonna leave this one loose because I think that's quite nice. That one I stitched down a bit heavier because it was quite a thick lace and it would have flopped everywhere. This is really light and thin cotton, so it's not gonna need as much holding down as the heavier lace, so that's the reasoning behind that. Come on, tie a knot. That's what I want to do. Me being brave, showing you the back of my work. It's usually a hot mess. Will be by the time I'm finished, I'm no doubt. Well, I've ordered some more silk ribbons. It's getting very low on certain colours. Oh, rat. And I was bored the other night. So I went shopping. I really mustn't get bored. It wasn't that expensive, to be fair. It was only about £20, so I allow myself that kind of a treat every now and again. Especially as I had a commission order on Etsy, so that kind of paid for it basically, which is kind of why I do the old Etsy thing. Right, so there we are. That's the background nice and secure. That looks really good there actually. It's really nice and sparkly. I'll give you a close up in a second. And let me see how long we've been going. Oh, I think we'll make that do for the first one then. Right, okay. Pardon me. So I think I'll get the snowman on next. I want to get him situated and then I can take it from there. And this middle one, I wonder if that'll look all right. Should I overlap it, or I'm thinking about cutting it to shape. I might do that. Let me just have a look, and then I can always looking for my pencil. I can always cut another one. I've got plenty of white felt. Let's see if that sits on there a bit more nicer. Yeah, I like that. That's much better. Somehow neater. Cool. So when I say the button on. Yeah, I'm really chuffed I found my little robins. They were in my Christmas box, so that can go on. They are miniature. I can't remember the name of the company. Is it in the packaging? No, because I also got mini Christmas trees. It was last, not well, it was well before COVID, I think. Are they called Button Box? Don't know. They might be at the show again. If they are, I'll get details, and then everybody can, you know, if you want the little miniature robins, they're lovely. But they do all sorts of stuff. So in fact, hundreds of buttons. So anyway, I'm going to leave it there. I will come back and show you the stitching of the snowman, and might decide if we do something there actually. Because that's going to go there, isn't it? I might leave that empty and possibly maybe change that around a bit. Do some stitching on there because I like the pistol stitch on Suffolk Puffs. That looks really good. That could move up a little bit there. Because it's a bit empty there otherwise, isn't it? I need to put these arms under there and then the robin, so that will stick out there a bit. Might do some sort of a tree, like a, you know, a dead winter tree, a silhouette, an outline. Okay, I'll leave it there for now. Hope you enjoyed that, and I will come back with a part two. Right, see you on that one. Bye.